Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. So today's video is going to be a first impression and a wear test. And today I am going to try out this foundation from Stick Worky. This is their daily wear liquid foundation enriched with vitamin E. Interesting. And I just want to try this out for the first time in front of you guys. I know first impressions se kuch pata nahi chalta hai ki whether you are really liking this foundation or not, whether this foundation is your favorite or not, but I just want to give you guys my first impression thoughts. I just want to try it out for the first time in front of the camera, in front of you guys. And this foundation is actually very, very affordable. This is only for 124 rupees. It's like crazy, a 124 rupees foundation. So I just want to give this a try in front of you guys and a wear test as well. Without any further ado, let's get into this video. Make sure to like, comment and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Let's get started. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna moisturize my skin with this moisturizer. And just don't mind this situation right over here. I'm having that one bad hair day, so that's why. So for moisturizer, I'm gonna use this switch off the AC or get this moisturizing cream for oily skin actually, and this is from the brand called Happily Unmarried. And I am using this moisturizer because this is for oily skin and this is actually a mattifying moisturizer. It will actually moisturize your skin from underneath and it's specially designed for oily skin. So that's why I'm gonna use this moisturizer for today's video. And you guys know I am not a primer kind of person and I don't like using primers, so that's why. If you want to use primer, you can use, but I am someone, I like the finish of moisturizing my skin and then using a foundation. In fact I have only one primer with me and I don't really buy primer. So now I'm gonna moisturize a little bit more because I don't know why this area of my skin is feeling like dry. I don't know why. So I'm gonna use my Nivea moisturizer. You guys know this moisturizer is my favorite moisturizer. So I'm just gonna use this moisturizer on my skin, especially on this area. I don't know why, but this area is feeling really, really dry. Okay, so now I'm gonna use the foundation and on this side of my face I'm gonna use a brush, and on this side of my face I'm gonna use my beauty blender so that you guys can see which side looks good. So first of all, I'm gonna take my brush, and this brush is from Amazon, like a random Amazon brush. So I'm just gonna, this is actually very cheap and this brush really works well for me, that's why I use it. Now I'm gonna use the brush. Oh my god, this pump is not so good, like the packaging. Okay, oh, I forgot to mention the shade. This is in the shade Honey I Am Golden, because the shade range was not so good and I was like, I bought this online of course, so I was like totally confused which was my shade. But I think this is not bad actually, like actually the shade is matching. Okay, so this is like one layer on my skin right now, and this foundation is very liquidy, like very, very liquidy, and it's like, it's actually giving me a very light coverage. Like if you are a person who don't like full coverage foundation, this foundation, obviously this says that it's a daily wear foundation, and you guys can see a glow right over here. Like this foundation is also hydrating, so I think it's looking pretty good right over here. I am also gonna put another layer because this is like a very, very light layer. You can obviously see my acne marks and everything. So far so good, and I don't think I'm gonna complain anything about. I think it's looking pretty good. Okay, so I'm just gonna take my blender and I'm just gonna use it. The pump is really, really, like the packaging is really bad guys. I'm just scared it's gonna get everywhere. Yeah. As you can see, this foundation is very, very liquidy. And then I'm just gonna blend it out. The blender side, and I am really liking this side. Like, both of this, you can't really see a difference, but I can see like this side is looking, the finish over here is looking more good. I don't know why, but I can feel that finish is pretty good. Like, you can't really see a difference, but I think over here it's looking more natural and more glowy, and the finish is looking more good, like over here. Rather than this side is also looking good, but this side is looking more good. If you want a coverage from this foundation, you have to use a brush. If you don't want any kind of coverage, just you want to use this foundation for your daily wear, just use a beauty blender and you're good to go. So this is the second layer I used, and this is how my skin is looking right now. Like, it's giving me a little bit of coverage. Overall, I can see the foundation is looking good and my skin is also looking healthy. This area, the nose area, which is the problematic area for me, is not looking good. Like, this part is looking like it's cakey. The foundation is not at all sitting over here. I don't know why. I've exfoliated as well, but I don't know what is the problem right over here. The foundation is not sitting properly on my nose. Rather than that, my skin is feeling very healthy. I can touch my skin, a little bit tacky, but it's not a big deal. Rather than that, the foundation over here, this side, the beauty blender side, is like more good, looking more good and healthy. I'm just gonna finish off with my makeup. It's like normal bronzing, blush and concealer, all this thing. But the products will mention down in the description box below. So I'm just gonna go and finish off with my makeup. How my makeup is looking right now, all glammed up. And I just want to quickly mention a few things before the wear test, that I used my Rimmel London Stay Matte Long Lasting Powder to set my foundation, and this is my absolute favorite and my go-to powder. Or is video pe maine kuch bhi aisa product nahi use kiya jo naya hai, except the foundation. Nothing is new, everything is my go-to favorite kind of thing. So obviously I'm using a foundation, I'm testing out a foundation, so I don't want to use anything new. So that's why when I used this powder, my skin and my makeup was looking like, my foundation was looking more good. I will not prefer this foundation. If you want to use this with a brush, please don't use this with a brush, because is side pe I can see my skin was looking very cakey. I can see pores and I can see lines. Maybe it can be like what brush I am using, depending upon that. But still, this is my go-to brush, and I use so many foundation with this brush. I don't know. I exfoliated my skin as well, but this area is looking very, very like kind of textured. Rather than that, this area is looking very nice. My beauty blender side is like looking the best. Nothing, I cannot see any kind of problem over here. I will obviously prefer this foundation to use this with a beauty blender. So far so good. I cannot see any kind of problem rather than this area of my face and this area. So I am just gonna go now, and after that, after a few hours, I'm just gonna come back and update you guys about this foundation. What are my thoughts and what I think about this foundation. So I am just gonna quickly go now. It's been like 5 hours. This is what my foundation is looking right now. Like, I zoomed you guys in so that you guys can see a little bit. To be very honest, it's not looking bad actually. I can see there is no foundation over here, no foundation over here. It's not at all covering, it's not at all covering my skin anymore. Like, it's like kind of faded out. But rather than that, my skin is looking pretty shiny, looking kind of shiny and dewy. Like, if you're a dry skin person, you're gonna love this. but I'm also loving this. I love this dewy, like shiny kind of thing. So after a few hours, actually this foundation is looking shiny and glowy. So that's a good thing. As I already told you guys, I'm gonna like recommend this foundation with a beauty blender, not with a brush. I think I'm gonna give this foundation a 7 out of 10 for me, because the packaging is really really horrible. You guys can see so the packaging is really really horrible. So I am not a big fan about this packaging. Obviously it's a pump packaging and I really love pump packaging kind of foundation, but this was horrible. I think is this foundation is not a long lasting foundation. If you want a very long lasting kind of foundation, I think this is not the foundation you're gonna go for. So yeah guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys find this video helpful. The foundation link will be there in the description box below. Please make sure to check that out. The products will be mentioned in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching guys. I love you guys so much. Please make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys on my next video. Bye.